Let's look at expanding some logarithms. We basically want to, in a way, simplify. So first thing I see is we've got this y to the power of negative 2. I like to undo negative exponents quickly. Just go ahead and get that out of the way. So this is log base 12, x to the fifth power over y squared. Okay, first step. I see now we have division. We've got log of this stuff that is division. So I'm going to use my quotient rule. So this is log of 12x to the fifth minus log of y squared. Well, this could be broken down to be log of 12 plus log of x to the fifth power. This is being multiplied, so I use the product rule here. We're still subtracting log of y squared. And finally, notice we have exponents. And so we can use our power rule for those. We still have this log 12 plus 5 log x minus 2 log of y. So that looks pretty good there. You always could take this log of 12, break it down to be log of 4 plus log of 3 and just keep going with it. But I think this is good. We've really separated those kind of three things we see that are multiplying together. The 12, the x to the fifth power, the y to the power of negative 2. And that's how it all breaks down. Over here, natural log of x squared over the square root of 4x plus 1. All right, I'm going to jump on a quotient rule first. Natural log of x squared minus the natural log of 4x plus 1 raised to the power of 1 half. I'm just going to go ahead and take that square root and use a 1 half to represent that. So I've got this natural log of x squared over here. I'm going to go ahead and use that. Well, I'm going to use the power rule. I'm just going to go ahead and power rule twice here. Bring that squared there. Bring that that power of 1 half over here. So this is 2 natural log of x minus 1 half natural log of 4x plus 1. And looking at this, we don't have a rule for if we're adding two things in our logarithm. So I think we're really stuck right here. This is about as far as we can go with it. It looks like there would be a lot more. That's going to be as far as we can go. Now let's look at condensing some logarithms. So these are basically in expanded form. We want to write them as one logarithm. So the first thing we want to do if we want to condense some logs is we want to undo the power properties that have happened. So I'm going to rewrite this as log base 3 of x to the 4th power minus log base 3 of x plus 6 raised to the 1/3 power. So the first thing is I need to undo that power property there. Now, I see that I'm subtracting 2 log base 3s. Sorry, I didn't write that real quick. I'm subtracting 2 log base 3s. So what do I need to do? I need to take the first one and show it being divided because I can use my quotient rule. Log base 3 of x to the 4th over x plus 6 raised to the 1/3. If I'm subtracting, that is screaming at me to use my quotient rule. And so what is x plus 6 raised to the 1/3 power? This is the third root of x plus 6. And so now we have written it as one logarithm. And that's our goal. Over here, very similar. I am going to use that power rule first. So this is natural log of x minus 4 raised to the 6th power plus natural log of x raised to the 3rd power. And now since I am adding them this time, this is screaming at me to use the product property. This is natural log of x to the 3rd times x minus 4 to the 6th power. They're all being multiplied together. We really could multiply this all out, but that just sounds like a lot of work for not much reward. So I'd leave it like this, showing that first, hey, we did that. We undid the power rule. We moved the numbers from the inside to the exponent. And then because we are adding, we know we need to multiply those things that we're taking the log of together to write as one log of. And so I would leave it just like that.